Mosses are small, non-vascular flowerless plants. They become very popular nowadays, so let's identify the most common types of moss. This is Olecomium palustre, also known as ribbed bog moss. Ribbed bog moss is a genus of mosses of the family Olecomniaceae, with a circumpolar distribution. This type of moss has loose or dense tufts. Green to yellow above and brown below. Stems 1 to 11 cm tall, with numerous rhizoids in the leaf axis, but not at the very top. Star moss or Tortula ruralis. Tortuola is a genus of mosses in the Podiaceae family and Bryophyta class. This plant is quite striking because, as the name implies, it resembles a cluster of small stars. One of the most intriguing characteristics of star moss is its ability to go dormant for long periods of time. This is Caliurginella cuspidata, commonly known as pointed spear moss. It is medium in size and grows in groups with other bryophytes, or it forms green, yellow-green, or orange-brown patches. Shoots are typically 3 to 8 centimeters long, but can be longer, and are often red near the base. It is often found in the company of other robust mosses. Lucabrium glaucum, commonly known as pincushion moss, is a species of haplolepidious moss, dicranidae, with a wide distribution in eastern North America and Europe. This perennial evergreen moss grows acrocarpously, forming dense plant cushions. The stems are from 1 to 12 centimeters long, with a pale green color and turning brown with age. Entodon seductrix, also known as the seductive entodon moss, or shiny seductive moss. It is a species of Entodontaceae. It is a small plant that grows to be about 3 cm tall and spreads horizontally rather than vertically. The plant's leaves are ovate in shape and have a glossy surface. It grows quickly and has a delicate, feathery appearance. Before we continue with moss identification, I would like to show you this art of the nature. These huge hoof fungus are covered with different types of moss, all included in this video. They are so amazing and inspirational. I already have an idea for my next terrarium. Let's move on. Andersonia alesibra, or commonly known as spoon-leaved moss. Spoon-leaved moss is a moss that is shiny, green to greenish-yellow-brown in color, with creeping stems and ascending, intertwined branches that form deep mats. In comparison to most moss species, it is quite large and striking. This rock is covered with Rhytidiodelphus triquetris, also known as Big Shaggy Moss. In moderately rich forest habitats in the boreal regions and the Pacific Northwest, it is frequently the dominant moss species. Big shaggy moss is a large, loosely spreading leafy moss with pale green leaves that point in various directions. The sprout's shoots are reddish and irregularly branched. Christocastrensis, or commonly known as plume moss, is a forest moss that gets its name from its feathery shape. It is a moss species within the family Pilaceaceae, thriving in ground-level forest conditions. Plume moss prefers shaded environments. The leaves curve strongly, pointing toward the base of the main shoot. Plume moss is one of the most common moss species in the forest zone. Centricia latifolia hubiner, and commonly known as water screw moss, is a species of moss belonging to the family Podiaceae. This moss has a very decorative appearance, with small broad leaves packed in circles around the stems to resemble a carpet of tiny green flowers. If you want to know how to make moss terrarium, I'll leave a link in the description. If you like my content, please support my channel by clicking on the subscribe button. It means a lot to me, and it's completely free for you. Thanks for watching.